Okay, back again, part two. Right. So you can see the sort of colours. It's pretty much dried off now, it's dry enough for me to work on. So I've got that in front of me, obviously. I don't think you can see that, but you can definitely see the reflections looking at what I can see on my screen. Trying to do what I can about that. How's that for you? Maybe I should up that. There we go. This out probably further than it should go, but I can put it up as far as that. Okay, that is slightly different. See, I've made a mistake there. Covered in paint, as per the usual. Okay. Pretty sure it's a bit of cobalt next. Only need tiny little amounts of paint, don't go overboard. A bit more than I put on there, but not much more. I do get great, you can't paint like this with onto canvas. Just can't slide it across the surface, the side. You can be quite economic with your paints, which is always appealing to painters. Staged in that one, the other one. Right. Powder blue next. to time. Shouldn't take too long, this part usually takes about 15-20 minutes. It's a bit of hair dry treatment, and I can just plant it straight onto the page then. The Jimmy. It has a completely different context in Britain. Usually I would be drying these off, but I'm going to save you and me the noise and the bother. Hopefully I can shortcut a bit. So far so good. So I'll put it from the other side. Yeah, I think we're pretty close to it so thus far. This is a phthalo turquoise now. Sometimes it doesn't help having something to work from in front of you. is going to be one small difference, and it's too late now, I've gone over the bit. We'll see if you can spot it. There's a hint, it's obviously something to do with this band that I'm working on here. There, 12-13 minutes. Right, this is Phthalo Blue. Going in next. Get that off my hands. It's not smearing it all over the place. Sorry. Okay, right, I am going to hair dry it now because the next colour is going to be buff titanium. Sorry, that was a bit off camera then, wasn't it? That's what it looks like on the other side. So it's pretty close. So it's, I'm going to go over it with the hairdryer now because I don't want to get any of the blue going into the buff titanium light that I'm about to put on. So I'm going to switch the sound off and it'll be back with sound in a minute. reasonably. I'm going to add a little bit of texture. This probably going quite heavy with it, not too heavy on the edges though, Josh. So there's the blue coming through, that's exactly what I didn't want. Never mind, too late now. Quick blast with a hairdryer again. Sound off, sorry. Okay, right, I'm going to get ready because I'll just drop this down onto it. So it's a matter of being preparation is key as ever. Got a nice clear surface ready for me to dive. I'll drop this out. This is cadmium orange, borderline red. Right, so the paint's quite thick on there, so I go in quite heavy with this, but it's probably I'm being a bit excessive here, because I'm just going to roller this over the top, but I want it in. There's a lot for it to cover. Roller out the excess paint, I'm sure I don't need to tell you that. do this without getting in your way. Which is not, I'm sorry, I'm just going to have to get my, I need to get right over the top of it. That's it. Right. So, much like what I was saying about pressing the line I print, start at the centre, plenty of purchase on that surface, and then work your way out from the centre. A bit like framing, you know, when you're stretching the your canvases, for those of you that use canvas, which is a surface I'm definitely interested in printing onto with this. Right, so what ordinarily I would do as well at this point, just to make double sure, I mean it's pretty much going to dry onto there. Sorry about going off camera here. I would give it a roll out on the back as well. Again, don't go mad. But I have been finding leaving these to dry that way up is quite helpful. I've also been finding, and I'll try to remember to do this when I do the next, the final stage of this, when I film the reveal, that lifting the plate away from the paper rather than the paper away from the plate holds, is, you've got a, it seems to have a higher propensity of holding of the what you intend to print onto the paper staying there. I'm sure people, there's plenty of people using thicker acrylic there, but it is reasonably thick on here, and if you don't let it dry properly, which is a good few hours, then it, you're just lifting whatever the fastest drying surface or colour is, depending on the viscosity of the paints that you, obviously if you're using, like I have been, metallic and then opaque acrylic, they've got wildly differing drying times, even just between normal medium body acrylics. Like I had to, you could see it took me quite a while to dry the titanium buff, whereas the phthalo blue and the phthalo turquoise doesn't take that long to dry. Anyway, so yeah, apologies for, obviously I realise you're getting this through a very interference field, isn't it? It's a bit like gravitational lensing now. I'm using all the dirt on the perspex to bend the light so you can see the circle, the lens. Maybe that's what I should call that one, gravitational lensing. There you go. Right, anyway, now I'll think about that while it's drying. Thanks for watching. If you can hit subscribe, any comments, you wanna, you're interested in buying it or buying any of these pieces, drop me a line. I'm generally around most of the time. I get back to you pretty quickly. Okay, thanks a lot for watching.